Breaking: woman with damning pictures Hillary didn't want out just found dead by insane incident. Another day and another dead body with a connection that cannot be ignored, as Hillary Clinton's body count seems to be on the rise once again, after a brief reprieve of no sudden, mysterious casualties. The latest is possibly the most shocking yet in the truly startling trail of dead bodies that keep accumulating around this crooked woman with major secrets she's desperate to keep hidden no matter who she has to kill off to ensure it. The latest victim was added to the list of Clinton casualties after it was discovered what photos she had that exposed the scandalous couple, but unfortunately for the Clintons, copies of those pictures still exist, even after the victim in them has perished. In what was originally reported as a freak and unfortunate house fire is far more mysterious than is being said, based on who is now dead in their own home. Before the deceased was a victim of a residential fire, she was allegedly a victim of something else and has photos to prove it, which are now coming back to haunt the Clintons after another dead body tied to them now has proof of one of Bill's biggest secrets. This latest alarming incident sure seems like a convenient excuse to cover up a connection to the couple whose names always seems to come up in random tragic events like this. The Daily Mail reports. As more and more women line up to tell their stories about sex with Bill Clinton, both consensual and forced, there is one who is unable to relive the details of her alleged affair. Penthouse bed Judy Gibbs died in a mysterious house fire in 1986 amid rumors that she had pictures that proved she and the then governor of Arkansas had been regular sex partners. And even now, 30 years after she died alongside her much older other lover, doubts remain about how and why Gibbs and her longtime beau Bill Puterbaugh met their grisly deaths. But now DailyMail.com has pieced together the life and death of Judy Gibbs, telling for the first time how the auburn-haired woman from a pinprick of an Arkansas town managed to bed the man who went on to be one of the most powerful men in the world. And the question remains unanswered: was Judy Gibbs killed because Bill Clinton and his advisors feared the affair was about to become public? I have always been convinced that Bill Clinton was responsible for the fire, but I have no proof, Gibbs' older sister Martha, who still lives in Sims, Arkansas, told DailyMail.com. And what would happen if I had proof? You can't touch those people. At the time of her death, Gibbs was 32 and living with 57-year-old developer Puterbaugh in a large isolated home a quarter-mile drive opposite a tiny airport outside Fordyce, Arkansas. Their bodies were both found in the huge master bedroom. They died of smoke inhalation. Puterbaugh's son, Randy, who followed him into the real estate business, tells a similar story to Martha Gibbs, even though the two have not spoken since the days following the double death. There are so many pieces of the puzzle, Puterbaugh said. I believe it is a possibility that Bill Clinton was involved in their deaths. I know I wish I had hired my own private investigator, but I didn't, so I guess I will never know. When so many people around and connected the Clintons in a number of ways that could be bad for them have been found dead, it can't be coincidental. It's time to start taking a closer look at all of these cases, both current and digging up those from the past, where there are probably far more mysterious deaths than what's come up recently. Mail Online pointed this fact out with alarming facts that Democrats insist on ignoring to save the Clintons from indictment they deserve. Many people around the Clintons have died in unusual circumstances over the years, leading conspiracy theorists to claim they could be connected. As DailyMail.com reported earlier this year, five deaths in a six-week span between June 22 and August 2 this year had connections to the former first family. I'm not saying the Clintons kill people. I'm saying a lot of people around the Clintons turn up dead, Larry Nichols, who worked with the former first family before turning against them, told DailyMail.com. And the names of Judy Gibbs and her lover Bill Puterbaugh could be added to that list. Of all of the recent allegations of sexual misconduct by politicians and people in Hollywood, the biggest predator Bill Clinton, who will never face the consequences of his actions. More importantly, Hillary Clinton never seems to be able to escape scandal, and as long as she's a free woman, rather than being locked up where she belongs, she will be continued to be questioned in everything that she has any kind of connection to.